Hi, this is Sean, your broker extraordinaire here at St. Augustine Team Realty. I'm going to give you a link to a video blog I did just like 5 seconds ago with my son, Zach, who was running around the office, and so I needed to hold him while I did this video blog. So hopefully I'll post the video blog. If you don't see a link on this email for a video blog about pricing your home, that's because I decided not to go with it because it was too crazy. But it was cool anyway. All right, I was just real quick, short meeting. Next Tuesday, what is next Tuesday? Today is the 7th, so will that be the 14th? Next Tuesday, the 14th of November, 2011, I am going to 11:30 instead of doing this video meeting. We're gonna have, an in-person lunch workshop on business plans. Since we're getting closer to the end of the year and you might be trying to get a business plan for 2012, it's going to be real informal, unlike most of the things we do, which are very green and very electronic. We're actually going to be, this is kind of a pencil and paper meeting, and I'm going to kind of show you how to create a business plan and how to come up with meaningful sales goals and, things like average sales price, sales you need to do, how are you going to get those sales, etc. So that's next Tuesday. I was reading an Active Rain post this morning, and this guy posted, some realtor from, I don't know where he's from, but he posted a question kind of at large to the Active Rain community about how do I get more buyers. This guy apparently needs to make 4 sales before the end of the year or he's going to get kicked out of the office, and he wants to know how to get more buyers. And it's really interesting in this day and age of technology, how the realtors could really only come up with 2 solutions, all these, probably 100 realtors. So I'm going to go over those 2 with you first, and then I'm going to kind of put in my own 2 cents. The first is open house. Yes, the dreaded open house for a realtor. We're a little bit different in this market in terms of open houses. And the reason why is for the same reason that the Jacksonville Jaguars NFL franchise can't fill their stadium. Well, let's not visit the fact about their win-loss record. But part of the reason they can't fill their stadium, and Tampa can't fill their stadium, and Miami can't fill their stadium, and San Diego can't fill their stadium is because there's just too much else to do. We live in a warm weather climate. It's nice almost year round. On a Saturday or Sunday afternoon, people go out fishing, they go to the beach, they go to historic St. George Street. They go on art walks, they go to state parks, like me, they go mountain biking. Of course, I'm training now for St. Augustine Team cycling team. They've got soccer with the kids, we've got year-round baseball, year-round kids football, year-round soccer. We even got ice skating if you go to Jacksonville. There's all sorts of things you can do on a weekend that you just do not have in other cities, which, in other words, people in other cities, there just isn't that big a I got 4 minutes here. Okay. Sorry, I was just checking the screen. There's just a whole lot of other things that people can do in other cities, or they don't have other things to do. They don't have all the resources, so our population base is just spread all over the place. We're in a stable residential market, but even when we were in the hottest of the hot seller's market, where inventory was just as scarce as hen teeth, there were 2 buyers, sometimes 3 buyers for every property, open houses still wouldn't draw, and it was for that reason. The other reason is, more and more, we have created an electronic frontier of real estate listings. And a buyer doesn't have to go to an open house anymore. They can get off work, the kids go to bed, they get on the internet, and they can search for homes, and they can come up with some hot items. After about 2 or 3 weeks, they've probably picked an agent, and they don't have to go. If they do go to an open house, it's just because they're driving by and they were curious, but typically they already have an agent. So while it was suggested to do the open house, in our particular market, good market, bad market, it's never been much of a winner. 2 or 3 agents seem to have good luck with them, but they're a different breed of agent. Second thing you can do, they suggested, was get in touch with your existing customer base. Didn't say necessarily how. I mean, if you've got a customer and they would be comfortable with you calling them, and understand the ramifications that are from do not call, but understand, so don't call them if they're on do not call and you don't meet that business window that do not call sets up. But if they would be comfortable with you calling them, well, maybe it might be good to give them a call. Stop by, write them a letter, send them an email. If there's a way that you feel comfortable and they would feel comfortable, now the salespeople are going to go, no, you just call them up and you say, hey,
Have you got any interest in buying or selling property now or in the near future? Well, thank you. Do you know anybody who else who can? No? Thank you. You know, there are some guys that can do that. And there are some people that are receptive to that on the phone. You know, we live in the real world of Times Square where we're being hit with ads every second of the day, and they might not appreciate it. So if there's a good way that you can, but if you can reconnect with your customer base, you will make sales because they will have someone or know someone if they like you that will help you, that will give you a lead to someone else you can contact to perhaps list or sell them a home. That's all I have this week. I guess I already put my 2 cents in about these each two options. The buyer's agents in this office are amazing at finding leads independently of buyers. So that was the last thing I wanted to add. You guys do a great job. Peter, Diacini, Monica, Kim, Deb, Kate, Ron, I'm forgetting you. I know I'm forgetting you. I always forget one or two agents. Oh, myself. Susie, don't hold it against me. Anyway, you guys do a great job setting up that electronic career and finding your buyers. These are maybe just a few more ways. So have a great week. Hopefully I'll see you next Tuesday for our business planning workshop. And that's it. You are the best agents in St. Augustine. We've got the best single team. We are a single cohesive unit that sells real estate constantly. Have a great one.